After 50 years, assassin of a snapper, and it there were some benefits that were associated with walls around cities. As a matter of fact, when we talk about walls in our current generation, when you build a house and you are unable to build a wall around it, you do not enjoy certain security benefits. Because everyone can enter into your house and leave. Everyone can enter into your house and pick anything. Anybody can even come into your house and say anything they want. But if you have a wall around your house and the wall has a gate, before somebody will enter, the person will have to knock. You will decide whether the person should enter into your house or not. So walls have benefits. But above all these things, walls have other benefits. Spiritually, walls have benefits. And the kind of walls that we are talking about that we are supposed to enjoy in salvation has spiritual benefits. Hallelujah. We are going to pray very soon. I am just raising some prayer topics and then we will stand on those prayer topics to pray. This is a message that I shared with a group of people not long ago. And we stood on it and prayed. And the hand of God descended mightily on us. I am believing God that He is going to descend on us today. Because there are some walls that are supposed to be around Christians. But by our own doing, we have tore down those walls. So witches and wizards can enter into our lives just anyhow. Demons can just enter into our house just anyhow. Human beings can just enter into our house anyhow. And they can just enter into our lives as well. And do whatever they want to us. But as a Christian, it is not supposed to be so. This is the reason why God has touched me to share this message with you. So that when we finish and we stand on this message to pray, every wall, spiritual wall that is supposed to be around you, we will build it today. And every wall that is around you that has been broken, it will be rebuilt. And every wall that is supposed to be around you that has not been built so far, we will start and lay the foundation today. And we will build it today. And it will glorify the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So, when we go back to the book of Nehemiah, chapter 4, verse 6. Please be on your feet as we do this small exercise. Kindly be on your feet. We are going to pray some two short prayers to prepare ourselves for the work ahead. Because there is a work ahead that needs to be done. So we will need to pray these two short prayers to prepare ourselves for the work that we are going to do tonight. Oh, tell your brother, I will work tonight. Tell your sister, I will work tonight. Because there are some walls that need to be built. And we are going to build them. Nehemiah chapter 4 verse 6. Kindly project it. Good.
So built we the wall. Good. And all the wall was joined together unto the half thereof, for the people had a mind to work.
Kindly lay your hand on your head and say, God.
God.
Father God.
Give me a mind.
To work tonight.
Work tonight.
Because there is a wall. In my life, that is supposed to be built. As I have come here today, and I have laid it upon my heart to build this wall, kindly give me the mind to work. Kindly give me the mind to work so that I'll be able to build a wall. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and pray. I'm not going to be able to do that. Christ. When we turn to Nehemiah chapter 6 verse 9. Nehemiah chapter 6 verse 9.
Nehemiah 6.
Can you read it? After they got the mind to work and they started the work, Sambalat and Tobiah began to confuse them, and they had to stand up again and say another form of prayer. Tonight there are some people that are going to dissuade us, some circumstances, even some things that we have done in our minds. It has brought a kind of wall that is going to prevent us, a stronghold that is going to talk to us, and let us refuse to build the wall that we are going to build. Every hand of Sambalat,
my God,
every hand of Tobiah that will rise against your ashes tonight, and with your resolution to build the wall tonight, let us do just pray. Second prayer,
my God,
he says that
for they all make us afraid, saying, their hands shall be weakened from the work that it be not done. Now therefore, O God, strengthen my hands.
Lift up your hand. Lift up your hand. What's it? I want it for the tea. So why you want to say, who may see a first one?
My God.
What more cancer? No, I'm here. You are going to be a woman. I'm going to be a woman. Send me a day out here. What shall I see? And who's going to be? Anything that I have a bomb by yourself. I will be a bomb. So I'm going to be a woman. I'm going to be a woman.
Nehemiah 2:17-20.
stood up and called the children of Israel and told them to come together so that they can rebuild the broken wall. I've already told you that salvation is a wall. Every Christian is supposed to have a wall around you, a wall that will protect you. Spiritually, there are walls that protect us. When the walls get broken down, you need to rebuild. There are some people, when you see them, even if you don't have eyes, you can see that this person has no wall around. Spiritually, they are just walking around. They are like chicken without owner. Any person can just touch it and use it for steel. Nehemiah called the people together and said, come, let us rebuild. But tonight I want us to actually consider what actually caused the walls being broken. Because when God promised the children of Israel the land of Canaan, he told them that he was going to bless them with a land that is flowing with milk and honey. Walled cities. And truly, he gave them walled cities. There were certain cities that did not have walls around them, but he gave them the strength to build walls around them. There were certain cities that had walls, but God collapsed those walls, and then he made Israel build their own walls. But then he gave them also a portion. Before they were about to enter the land of Canaan, God told them in Deuteronomy chapter 12, verse 3. Let's go there. Deuteronomy chapter 12, verse 3. God told them something. That is what actually caused the walls being broken.
My God. Deuteronomy 12, verse 3. And ye shall overthrow the waters and break the ruins, and burn the ropes with fire, and ye shall hew down the graven images, the gods, and destroy the names of them out of that place. Verse 4. Ye shall not do so unto the Lord your God.
It's okay. This is a message that can be confusing if you don't understand it. So let me take some small time to interpret or let you understand this message. Abraham is like for a new Rakina. When I'm going to go to Akumaso, everybody to Moses Akumaso, catching his life for the same. Or my Nakuka, the Munipanit, Nanipano, one year that you are getting a bit too. And it is a move that's our mind. Why are you asking someone when you're in a mammo follow? Mammo copy and obey. Mumu, when I was from a city, then move on. Now, to two more high places, and it near my yard, when the summer coming, I would be good for my. And was uncle from Puno. Mamma, don't have pity on them. Destroy all of them out of the face of the
head.
When we have no problem, say, oh, we are someone that put on numbers to catch his life. And so this life will work in us as Syria. One more nipple be more woman. One more appointment, nipple be to be the tricky woman. Give your mindset to be the tricky. This life for, and it's this life for no more papa. And I'm sapping into a man to me and come home. I've got over here a snare unto them. Let me tell you, the truth of the matter is, salvation also was a promise. It was promised with a word, but it also comes with its do's and don'ts. There are certain things that we are not supposed to do as Christians. And so if we forget about them, and if we begin to play with the mercy and the grace of God, and we begin to do certain things that we are not supposed to do, the walls that are supposed to be around us, it will be broken. And once the walls are broken, we are going to be miserable. So today you see a Christian with a promise from God that as a Christian you are supposed to be ruling the heathens. You are supposed to be ruling the heathens. You are supposed to be ruling the world. But then a Christian will go about begging for
trouble.
He will go about begging for money. He will go about begging for a place to sleep. So there is one thing that is going on. According to this book. Look, let me ask this simple message. Who has one of these devices? Who in this house has one of these devices? A smartphone. Let me tell you, smartphones were built to dominate the market. When they are building smartphones, they build it with the intention of dominating the market. It has this kind of dominion principle behind it. And when you buy it, it dominates you. It takes over your mind. And it makes you something like dependent on it. So there is no way you can live a whole day without your phone. Even some people, after 1 minute, they have to take their phone. Every second, they have to go to their phone. Now, in the olden days, our phones were just for calls. But then they began to think, people like bitches. When you enter into somebody's home, you ask for their album. They said, let us do it in such a way that their phones will be their album. Their phones will be their workman. Because in the olden days, when you meet somebody and the person is in town, he must have a workman with earphones. And when he's walking around, he's listening to music, he's listening to messages. But today they make the phone to overtake the workman. So that that same phone, it is your workman, it is your camera, it is your album, it is your Bible. It can also be your source of entertainment, and it can also be your source of corruption. Because all what corrupts the mind can also exist on the phone. So you can see a Christian, and he has a phone, he has a Bible on it, but he also has pornography on it. So when they check the Bible, the phone, and they are torn between watching pornography or reading the Bible, before you realize they read the Bible for 10 seconds and they watch pornography for 1 hour and then they go to sleep. What kind of wall are you expecting to be around? Hallelujah. Tell your brother we are going to build a wall. You see, there is one thing. Everything that Satan does, he does it in such a way that he will be able to capture your mind. He will be able to capture your desires. He will be able to capture everything that you think about, your thoughts. So even when there is a phone that God is blessing us with, Satan too will enter into the same phone, and then he can also use it to corrupt you. As a Christian, what has light got to do with darkness? How come a Christian has a mobile phone that has pornography and Bible on it? How come a Christian has a mobile phone that has Facebook and the Bible app on it? But early in the morning, when he takes the phone, he goes to Facebook first for 3 hours. But when he turns to the Bible and read for 10 seconds, he is dozing off. What is actually dominating you? There is something that is going on in the world. And we as Christians, unless we check it upon ourselves to reorder it, it shall not go well with us. Let us go to Isaiah chapter 9 verse 7. Isaiah chapter 9 verse 7. He says something there. Some people think he said it about only Christ. But whatever is about Christ, it's also about you. He said of his increase, of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it and to establish it and with judgment that were wrong. That is why God told them, when you enter into the land, pray or die. In Christianity, today, in our lives, there are certain things that are wrong. That is why God is calling us. And when He calls us, He gives us the mandate, He gives us the authority, He gives us the power to reorder. So that what is ever wrong in this world, whatever is wrong in our lives, we now put it right. Tell your brother, tell your sister, tonight we are going to put it right. Tonight we are going to reorder it. In the name of Jesus.
And of increase of his government and the peace, there shall be no end upon the throne of David, upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment.
So my dad say, I can't first do one thing, baby. Yeah, cause I first room. You see, a Christopher, a first room, it was a warrior. Then so a first room, the beauty a book. You should buy me a sword. Sending a young book on today, you say, young boy, you brand, you shall have. May prepare for this message and a Yakupo LED me. Not go hard right that they be woho. Yeah, me used to catch it. Let me say, suddenly me fire me connect the alibi. The first thing that I saw on the hard drive was an old hip life song. Naturally, my wife and everybody who knows me these days will testify. I don't have anything to do with hip life. But something was telling me strongly that you must watch this. So I opened it and then we started playing. And then God told me, look at the clothes they are wearing. Shantaria is strong. This is a song that was played about 17 years ago. And then, during that time, those clothes that they are wearing, they were supposed to be clothes worn by vagabonds. People that do not have people controlling them. But the same clothes, if you look at them carefully, today people are wearing it to church. When you go, just go and take any old hip life song. Look at the clothes that you were wearing in those days. I quite remember there was a day I experienced something at KJTR. A lady was wearing a glove and he was walking through the market. And then people were hooting at him. And they wanted to even tear off the clothes because the clothes were too short. But if I remember correctly, the clothes was something around here. Today people wear clothes around here to the church. There is only one thing that can change, which is not right. Change is a very good thing. Change is a very good thing. Change is a very good thing. But the only thing that when it changes, it is not good is morality. Morality. You cannot change morality because morality was ordered by God and it has been reordered by the world. We Christians are supposed to reorder it. We are not supposed to conform. That is why he is telling us, be ye not conformed, but be ye renewed, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. When you renew your mind, you have to also change these things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know if I'm treading on somebody's toes. I'm talking about five walls and we will stand on those walls to pray. Because these walls have been broken in our lives. Because of our time, I am going to list the walls one by one. And then we will pray based on the wall. But whatever I have said, I had a long message, but I am cutting it short because of time factor. So whatever you think is actually in your mind, that is telling you that, look, this is wrong. This is not how it is supposed to be done. Because somebody told me, the day I became a Christian, I started considering certain things. And I decided to consider them this way. Anything that I decide to do, I sit down and ask myself, if it was Jesus who was doing it, how will he do it? And then I pray about it before I do it. Whatever we are doing, the clothes that we are wearing, our behavior, our speech, the kind of music we listen to, ask yourself, the kind of movies we watch, the kind of pictures we watch, if it was Jesus, would he be watching them? If it was Jesus, would he be saying them? If it was Jesus, would he be doing them? If it is not like that, don't do it. By if it is like that,
I said, it's
you can't go ahead. Jesus had a wall.
Yes,
if you walk according to his steps,
the
wall will also be around you.
The first one is
you see,
mission.
There is one thing that is wrong with us. When it comes to holy life, we want to live it for God. But the only thing that Jesus Christ is to give us the image of God. My brother, my sister, when Jesus came, what he brought us is not the qualities of God. Jesus didn't give us omnipotence. God didn't give us omnipresence. God didn't give us omnipresence. God didn't give us omnipotence. But God gave us his nature. And the nature of Jesus. The nature of Jesus is the character of Jesus. It is the character of God. In summation, God is love. And so he brought us love. And everything that is associated with love, this is what we are supposed to complement. Everything that is good, everything that is right, everything that is of good, good report, that is what we are supposed to do. And that is what will build a wall around us. There are five major kinds of walls that I want to lift. And then we will start on them to pray. The first one is the wall of good men.
Good.
The wall of good men.
Our first word, any pen, and your first war, and papa.
Nipapapa.
My dog.
It's not the same nipapapa. It's me, our first woman. Say, First Samuel chapter 25, verse 15 to 16. What's it? Abra David and then the chief one now someone let go of one woman who put that ransom. Omoko Kumu, Papa, na Papa, no, na Nimai Evo, Srenosu, AD. His son is David and then the chief one, no, we Papa Penti. Look at the report that was made concerning them.
25 and 15. But the men were very good unto us, and we were not hurt, neither miss. Anything as long as we were conversant with them when we were in the field, verse 16, they were a wall unto us both by night and day.
They were a wall unto us
both night
and day. Anything about every profound about no idea about money, but a man no more than a man who was selling some. As I get into Papenti, one in every field for the bush and for a year, a first who a child about Japan, you try it in a bad man. Say, there was selling some, the big Yangra, the Sanson, not David in the bush and for no more than Papa. Oh, yes, it's our first who can you wish, and it's a big Yangra. You're sorry, I am not sorry, me. The Pompai, the one Papa, the year was for my brother. The one now for me was a young one, and then I'm for the phrase and your colony, and then I'm for the phrase and your colony, and then I'm for the phrase and your passion, and then I'm for my phone. That is all my data for police bringing for my data for. What would I say? I'm going to open my tabata or one. Or when you have first room, you tell me, she's a brand that goes here, you will put just my brand that goes here, I'm going for two years. A man that goes for two months, I put up on you. Some crowd may have first week, I was here, but I was a first room. I said, the young couple in my back, 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 the young couple in my back,
my God.
But I don't understand some people. Some of us don't seem to understand what we are doing. There are some people around you. You see them as wolves. But when harm is coming, they step aside. And the harm will come through them to you. But there are some people who are supposed to be around you. That is supposed to be a wall of protection around you. Good people that God is supposed to send to you. We are going to pray and sack every evil person in our life. And then we are going to pray and ask God to pave way to attract good people into our lives. Begin to pray. Because at times, what we have in our pockets, what we have in the bank, what we have in our home, can also be a wall around us. Look, would you say, would you complain? But why that boy in the phone? No affair. When he for me, and the best in 5 seconds, that's what you're for me to interview. See, come with you. Come with Timu. Can you have some group police station? First thing a police in the desire, they say, well, license way. We in the license in the chair, I will say, call, yeah, the license in the call license office, I call you, say, you're genuine. And yet, you're not. And yet, you're call, you know, now you're the car to go home. So on Coco CSC, Nipa Chronica, so on Penn and Wassam Susodia, won't find a license, no, no, won't feel won't go. Now, only the Panicas are departing the channel. Meanwhile, Mimiano, Nipa Chronu Kitunino, Minias of Chikia Sorrent, and if we know Yana expenses and Pomoda force in Panama Yamano, would this car? Look, tonight. There is supposed to be a certain amount of wealth in our hands. Because the rich man's wealth is a strong city and has a high wall in his own conceit. But you see, when it is in your conceit, fine. But still it is a wall. Every rich man, your wealth is your strong city. This is where when you enter, your strength is expressed. Let us raise up our hands. Say, Our Father. You said the heathens will serve us. Who can say, I'm a man for no best soul yet? Who can say, I'm a man for no best soul yet?
Will be at the beginning of the book, guys. You can money. There is a camera brand, you won't worry, you won't shepherd.
Life, and
A good man, but there are godly men
Let's go to Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 20. Men that are God fearing are supposed to be around you. Can mommy can say me? Who bad sorry ya oh? A Christopher ever said that he first will change your Indonesia. Oh, as upon some other way you, if you have a Christopher near, what's your body me a whole Bible? What do you do for concern the same me? As aside them, our neck was said. These godly men should be the world around us. Some people were called into the life of Apostle Emmanuel Apa to be a wall around the man, so that in times of trouble you will defend him. But this time round, and from concern, and the area sit near my paint. Young woman, I yet said here was your bubble back. These are godly men that God is electing through the church. But I told you, because of time factor, we wouldn't consider the effect of Sambalat and Tobiah. Because Sambalat and Tobiah, they were human beings in those days. But right now, they are spirits. They are still roaming about. When they see you doing something, they come to confuse you. They come to stop you. They will do everything to weaken your heart, so that you will not be able to do what you are supposed to do. There is an assignment on this man's life. The Apostle Emmanuel Apa has an assignment. And that is why God has elected us good men, godly men, to surround him. There is also an assignment in your life. You yourself, there is an assignment. And your brother too has an assignment. That is why God has called you and given you that mandate to protect them. We are not supposed to tell them now. Let us read.
Jeremiah 15:20. And I will make thee unto these people a fence-raising wall, and they shall fight against thee, but they shall not prevail against thee, for I am with thee to save thee and to deliver thee, said the Lord.
Peter was supposed to kiss him. And God said, I'm going to kiss him, but I'm going. What's it? And I will make you unto these people a fence-raising wall.
But the papa, Jesus.
be with him, and he had no trust. Look, if you are an iron pillar,